Welcome back to another Daily Walk. Well, today I want to talk a little bit about what is truth. Because I was reading in this section from the Gospel of John today. This is John 18. Forgot my Bible, so I have to do it on the phone here. So Jesus and Pilate are talking, and Pilate wants to know if Jesus is the king. He says, "Are you the king of the Jews?" This is verse 33. And Jesus answered, "Are you saying this on your own initiative, or did others tell you about me?" And Pilate says, "I'm not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and chief priests delivered you to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, he says, "My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then my servants would be fighting so that I would not be handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not of this realm." Therefore, Pilate said to him, "So you are a king?" And Jesus answered, "You say correctly that I am a king. For this I have been born, and for this I have come to the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice." And Pilate said to him, "What is truth?" And when he said this, he went out again to the Jews and said to them, "I find no guilt in him." This is interesting. We have Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor at the time, and he's here talking with Jesus. And he says, "Are you a king?" He says, "I have come to testify to the truth." And he says, "What is truth?" Of the very person who is the only one in the world who could actually answer that question. And then he turned around and walked away before he could even answer. And he says, "I don't find anything wrong with this guy. Let's have him back." But what is truth? What is truth? "I am the way and the truth and the life," Jesus writes in John 14:6. "Nobody can come to the Father except through him." And so this is an interesting discussion as we talk about what is the truth in the light of all of our crazy world, because we have hit this world where we are so postmodern, we cannot even discern our gender anymore. Okay, we pushed away against God, running towards science, but we have this fundamental problem that science no longer agrees with the thoughts inside of our head. And so now we've cast off science and created a life around us based upon our own subjective realities. And that is postmodernism. So what is postmodernism? This is the philosophy. So you have to understand what postmodernism you have to understand what modernism is. So to do that, you might want to understand what is pre-modernism. Three overarching dominating views which have to do basically and fundamentally with truth. In pre-modernism, truth was defined by the religious subset. Now, that may or may not have been the Christian God, but whatever it is, this is what dominated society for most of its existence. We believed in some form of deity, and so we placed our trust in that deity to tell us the way to be. Now, whether that deity was Jesus or Allah or Buddha is up for separate debate, but all of those have in view that in pre-modernism, it is the deity that is the ultimate arbiter of truth. Modernism came about around the Industrial Revolution when we started to believe that we can actually solve society's problems. We can generate enough food to feed everybody, and we have. We have more than enough food to feed everyone on this planet a few times over. The problem is most people can't buy it. And Jesus said, "The poor will always be with you." So we're not exactly going to solve poverty anytime soon. Not that we shouldn't try. But the ultimate point here I want to make in looking at all this is that modernism is when we attempted to solve the world's problems. In other words, we pursued the absolute truth, and the absolute truth was no longer found in a deity, but inside of man's industrial accomplishments. That was modernism. But then we survived a couple hundred years of modernism, and we still had issues, we still had problems, we still had challenges. There were still serious consequences. We were not able to solve our poverty. We were not able to solve our hunger. We were not able to solve our diseases. And so what ended up happening is this new philosophy spawned out of this that is called postmodernism. Postmodernism says one of two things, and there's no single firm definition, but two general ideas in postmodernism. One of those is that there is no absolute truth. The other of those is that if there is an absolute truth, we cannot know it. So what do you do? Well, you eat, you drink, and you be merry, for tomorrow you die. That's what Paul writes in 1 Corinthians. If there is no God, if there is no resurrection, let's just go and enjoy our lives. Well, this gives rise to the one true American philosophy called existentialism. So existentialism, excuse me, that's not correct. Existentialism is not American. The American philosophy is pragmatism, which we're not talking about in this video. Pragmatism is do whatever works, irregardless of the morality behind it. That's the American philosophy. I misspoke. Existentialism, yes, does come back from the European areas. So existentialism, though, is the philosophy of postmodernism. Existentialism is to postmodernism what recreational marijuana is to medical marijuana. So there's a lot of people that want to get medical marijuana approved because that would be a stepping stone to legalizing marijuana for even recreational use. Well, postmodernism says there is no absolute truth, and existentialism says I don't want there to be any truth, because if there's truth, that will possibly interfere with my own joy and my own pleasure. So Aldous Huxley, of course, was famous, a famous existentialist. He said, I do not want there to be a God because that frees me to engage in my lusty passions. Okay, so we have this idea of philosophies. So existentialism is truly a philosophy of postmodernism. It says there is no absolute truth. There is no absolute morality. Truth is in the eye of the beholder, and we have to do whatever feels good. So that is the society we're living in now. Pontius Pilate asks Jesus, what is truth? And he walked away before Jesus could get him the answer. What is truth? The truth is that Jesus Christ is the way and the truth and the life. Jesus Christ is truth. So truth, if we look at what the definition of truth would be, we would say it's fidelity to a standard. Okay? So fidelity meaning adherence to and a standard. Fidelity to a standard, that is what absolute truth would be. What is the standard? That is the question. In a postmodern society where we cannot even discern our gender by looking in our pants, our own subjective reality becomes the thing by which we insist that the rest of the world agrees with. In other words, we oftentimes nowadays insist that the whole rest of the world goes along with what we have inside of our mind. This is what happens when we have rejected God to the nth degree. We have adopted postmodernism. So what is truth? It is the character of God. Truth is the character of God. It is the fact that there is an absolute reality. I may not be able to understand everything here all together, all at once. But there is an absolute reality. There is an absolute truth. And it is our imperative to learn more and more about the character of God that we may know what truth is. This is why he tells us in Romans to be transform yourself by the renewing of your mind. Do not conform yourselves any longer to the patterns of this world, but transform yourself by the renewing of your minds. Learn who God is. Spend the time learning the scripture, because the scripture as we have it, which is true to history, it is true and faithful to the original writings, even the modern English languages. Now, we have to be careful. There's too many modern English languages. Don't read the Toleration Bible or the Queen James. I recommend the NASB, the New King James, the Holman, the English Standard Version. If you like the older English, the King James is okay. You know, we have a lot of these things, but, you know, just because something is translated in the last 50 years doesn't mean it's heretical. I would avoid the NIV because of some of the more recent changes they've made to it. The old 85 version was very good. Modern versions, not so much. There's a lot of other ones that are coming out now that it's like they're doing translations just to sell books. I don't know what the deal with that happens to be. So with that being said, consider that is truth. Truth is fidelity to the standard. That standard is God. That is what truth is. And if only Pontius Pilate would have stayed for the answer, we might have had that written and recorded as well. So thanks for coming along on this daily walk. You can help support the channel with the links in the description down below. Keep an eye out on the channel. We have a new book coming out here in the next couple of weeks. I'll have more information on that as soon as it is available. So thanks for coming along, and I hope that you enjoy your daily walk in our Lord.